Making his way to the cage, Daniel Reed, training out of Marty's Martial Arts with a record of 2-1.
Yeah, all those guys at Marty seem to be tough. I mean, you got John Kennedy there. That guy's had a grip of fights. I mean, I'm sure they push a young kid like this.
You see his brother, Justin Reed, right behind him. Daniel recently had a fight in Sturgis. He did come up short. He had a very tough fight, though, against John Ramirez. No, not an easy fight whatsoever. So I know he's looking to come back and get a win here tonight. He describes his fighting style as, well, unorthodox. He's hoping that his opponent's going to be throwing hands, which I think his opponent would be glad to accept.
Anytime you got two guys willing to stand in the middle of the cage and throw hands, that's always a good night for the fans.
Making his way into the cage, Daniel Reed.
And here we go, folks. Cain Lugar making his way to the cage. He's a 5-1 fighter out of Hard Drive in Cedar Rapids, Iowa. And anything we know about the guys from Hard Drive, they got a strong base up there.
Definitely a lot of wrestlers there. He used to train at PHF Karate in Mason City. This is his first fight making the switch there, as you see Mark Tong Van and a couple other Hard Drive guys.
Yeah, we'll see if the switch was the right choice. I'm sure it was. A lot of talent, like I said, coming out of Hard Drive, headed by Coach Keone Koch, who is the brother to Eric Koch, that fights in the UFC.
Cain's last fight was in the 145-pound division, title shot. He came up short, but he's a very good kickboxer. He has a lot of he's very well-rounded, I've noticed. He's got a couple submission wins, but he's primarily a stand-up fighter. Very, very good. What's the word I'm looking for?
Technical? Or?
Yeah, of course. Very technical stand-up fighter. His hands are always where they're supposed to be.
Yeah, with the record of 5-1, he's going to look to go ahead and overcome that last loss and get back to his winning ways.
I talked to him earlier, and he looked determined, and he looks ready tonight. Cain Lugar.
Ladies and gentlemen, our fourth bout of the evening is scheduled for 3 3-minute rounds in the Caged Aggression Amateur Featherweight Division. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He stands 5'10" tall and weighed in at 143 pounds. He trains with Marty's Martial Arts and is sponsored by La Rosa de Michoacan. Joining us from Rock Island, Illinois, Daniel Reed. And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. He stands 5'9" tall and weighed in at 144 pounds. He trains with Hard Drive MMA and is sponsored by Bud Light and Leading Edge Construction. Joining us from Mason City, Iowa, Cain Lugar.
And here we go, folks. We got Daniel Reed in the red, Cain Lugar in the blue. Looks like we're in for a nice one here this evening. Caged Aggression 16, the aftermath, ready to get after it.
Both fighters like to stand, so we should be looking for a stand-up war here.
Reed's corner's already calling for finding his rage in combos, and he starts off right away using that jab.
There you see the kicks by Lugar coming to play. Reed's laying some good pressure, though.
Into the ground they go.
That aggressiveness by Reed kind of cost him there, that takedown.
Yeah, Lugar put a little pressure on him, and they both went to the ground.
Reed tried to scramble up, and Lugar keeps his posture down. Reed trying to scramble, looking for arms, looking for any openings to try to scramble up.
Yeah, both guys spending a lot of energy right now. One trying to secure a position, the other one just doing what he can to try to get up. Lugar slips into a half guard here.
You see, he's got that right underhook, too, and that's going to keep him dominant on top
of
him.
Yeah, that'll be the key to controlling Reed while he's on the ground. He's looking to step over the arm.
He's trying to use that left knee, and good sweep nice there by Reed. Now, this is where Reed has to take advantage when he's on top.
Yeah, he's going to want to land some shots past the guard, and there goes Lugar with an arm bar. It looks tight, and he picks him up and drops him on his head twice. Sometimes that makes it deeper. That could be sometimes the bad move to do, but it looks like he might get out of it. He needs
to. Oh, it's deep, and he taps.
And there's the armbar victory. Karate obviously being a very good key.
Good job by Lugar, getting swept, remaining calm, and when your opponent's raining punches, to snatch an arm up and, take
right.
a victory there.
You've seen the kicks at the beginning of the fight. Obviously, karate is his style, but it looks like our drive has polished up his jiu-jitsu, and he was able to snap off an armbar victory here in the first round.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Bruce Allen, has called a stop to this contest with 1 minute, 25 seconds left in round one, declaring your winner by submission due to armbar, Cain Lugar!
Improving to 6-1, Cain Lugar out of Hard Drive MMA. A very nice armbar.
And again, he's back to his winning ways.